in our acoustic scene, where we're sat here in front of the camera, there are quite a few audio sources coming on. So I'm speaking, the interviewer's speaking, and they've got the air conditioning noise up in the ceiling. So you can think of that, as I say, as an acoustic scene, and every emitter of sound in that acoustic scene is a potential source, well, is a source. There's even the top of the clock ticking up on the wall, although that's a very, very quiet source. That's fundamentally what we mean by a source, is an individual emitter of sound in the acoustic scene. And what we're trying to do with blind source separation is to take the mix of those sources as they appear at the microphones, and take that mix and separate it out into the individual sources. So, you know, we can hear just me, or just, I mean, especially if you imagine there was two people talking at once. If I asked the interviewer to say 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, we were both talking at the same time. Ideally, when we're doing blind source separation, our objective is to separate the interviewer from me into one stream, and me from the interviewer into another stream, and so you get the two streams completely separate. Well, to do with whatever you want to do, which depends upon the application. Well, the way we approach it is as a Bayesian probability problem, and we use the statistics of the sources. There's an idea which is the central limit theorem that says any mixture becomes more Gaussian-like as you make a mixture, and that's what's happening at the microphones. They're picking up a mix of the sound sources. And so we're trying to find a transformation that maximises the heavy-tailedness of the output sources, and that's how we do the source separation. There's lots of synergies of blind source separation with other technologies. For example, when you do the blind source separation, okay, we not only do you separate the sources out really well compared to each other, the dominant sources, but you actually also do quite a significant amount of reduction to the ambient noise. So you will generally get the source of interest, or assuming you know which is the source of one of interest, but you'll get the source out plus a little bit of the ambient noise, but it's reduced. So then one thing you can do after that, as a processing after that, is then you can then use your noise reduction technologies to then reduce the noise even further. The blind source separation has removed the other sources that make noise reduction really difficult. So you've just got the one signal that you want plus ambient noise. That's perfect for noise reduction. So you then get a really good, much better overall signal quality out of the combination of BSS with noise reduction than just noise reduction, which can't solve the problem. And BSS will do a good job of reducing some of the noise, between 5 and 10 dBs, depending on the number of microphones. But it won't completely eliminate the background noise. So the combination really works well. And the other area that it works really well with, obviously, is with automatic speech recognition, on like in your voice assistants or something like that, because you're separating out the voice to a single voice. So if you've got two people talking simultaneously, then that's a hard problem for automatic speech recognition to actually work out what's being said. You've got two separate streams. So if you can use blind source separation, which is based much more on a sort of like the physics of the situation type approach to separate the sources, then that works. It gets a really good, highly intelligible single source plus a low level of ambient noise. That's again ideal for automatic speech recognition voice assistants to then go on and use further. So blind source separation you have to see as a valuable and very useful component in the whole audio system, depending upon what objective that you're trying to solve.